Hey mamas, it's your Cajun Stork here. Today I'm going to talk to you about 6 tips to have that natural birth that you're really looking for. But before I begin, my name is Midwife Kyra and I believe in truly natural birth because I know it makes for better birth experiences. Consider subscribing to my channel and joining us for our Midwife Monday videos each week. So when I talk with women about natural birth, I typically get 2 different responses. I get one group of women who believe that, well, we've had given birth since forever. So natural birth is a totally normal thing and I don't need to prepare for it. It's just gonna happen naturally. Okay, but then we have another group of women who know that natural birth in our society can be a little bit more of a challenge than we had expected it to be, especially when we're dealing with hospital policies, state mandated policies and things like that, that make having the natural unmedicated birth that we want a little bit more challenging. Policies that are not backed by evidence, by the way, things like being stuck in the bed, not being able to eat and drink during labor, just a lot of things that really reduce the likelihood that you're going to have the unmedicated birth that you're really looking for. Despite which group of these women that you fall into the category of, I think that having a natural birth really takes 6 really good steps, and I'm here to give those to you today. So tip number 1 is invest in a good childbirth education class. Many hospitals offer basic childbirth education for free as part of delivering in their facility. But what most women don't realize is what these classes are designed towards is more of how to be a good patient, not necessarily how to be a woman giving birth. And that is why investing in a good childbirth education class such as Lamaze, hypnobirthing, birth boot camp, classes such as those can really get you the information that you need to get the natural birth that you want. So it's more than just about learning, you know, what an epidural means, what it looks like, how long you stay postpartum. It's about learning about all the risks and benefits and all the alternatives, options that you have when you're in labor so that you can set yourself up for your best birth. So investing in a good childbirth education class can absolutely make the difference of a very peaceful birth where you feel like you have control and informed consent of your options versus a birth that may not be unfolding the way that you want it to and really feeling kind of lost and out of control with not having your voice heard. And it's just because we weren't educated in advance. Number 2, I want you guys to hire a birth doula. Now, you've probably seen my videos before on hiring birth doula and how I think they're so beneficial to a birth. And if you follow me on social media, just a few weeks ago, I made a post about doulas that went kind of, I call it Cajun viral, where just so many women were starting to understand how doulas can make a huge benefit for the birth from even the dad's perspective. So if you don't know what a doula is a birth support person, not a healthcare provider, but a birth support person who basically makes dad look good as he helps you and she helps you to have the unmedicated birth that you want. What most people don't realize is that birth doulas actually have statistics that prove that they reduce your risk of a C-section, they reduce your risk of unnecessary interventions, forcep deliveries, IV fluids, things like that, that may not be necessary in your birth process. Not to mention increasing the satisfaction with your birth. So hiring a doula can really make all the benefit in having the unmedicated natural birth that you're really looking for. They are worth the investment and I promise you they're cheaper than an epidural, so consider hiring a doula for your upcoming birth. Tip number 3, consider getting an out-of-hospital birth. It all starts with a consultation. I don't know a single midwife out there who doesn't offer clients the opportunity for a consultation first to not only address birth fears, but to also to find out if you and your midwife are a really good fit and that if you're even a candidate for an out-of-hospital birth. Out-of-hospital births increase the likelihood that you're going to have the natural birth that you're really looking for. A few months ago, I did a video and I was doing some research in my area. I live in Acadiana, which is a little area in Louisiana where we have some of the worst birth statistics in the country. And I found out that women planning a hospital birth in my area have about a 2-3% chance of having a truly natural, unmedicated birth that they're looking for. Meanwhile, in the same town, if they come over to my birth center, their chances are almost 90% that they're going to have the birth that they're looking for. Truly natural birth. And so midwives make all the difference in you getting the natural birth that you want. And you don't have to sacrifice safety to have a birth experience that you want. So I really want you guys to consider at least interviewing and consulting with a midwife and just seeing if it's a good fit for you and, you know, might be something you want to consider in the future. Tip number four is preparing your birth team in advance. Now, we just talked about hiring a midwife or an OBGYN, right? And we talked about adding a doula to your birth, but what about your other support team? What about people in place to take care of your older children so you can labor comfortably in your birth environment? Or maybe someone who can run errands for you, get you food and snacks, or someone to take care of dad, or even your pets while you're in labor. Birth teams don't just encompass who is going to be in the actual delivery room. It's about having your team set up for the birth and the postpartum. So when it comes to preparing your birth team, it all starts with your birth partner first, the person who is your biggest support person, usually the father of the baby or your spouse, who will be there for your birth. From there, we talked about doulas and also your birth provider, whether it's a midwife or an OBGYN. Some people choose to have extra people at the birth, a mother who's experienced a natural birth, or maybe a friend who they just feel like will be their rock during their birth experience. But it's really important that they prepare their birth team in advance, that you guys prepare your birth team so that you feel that you are well cared for and supported throughout the process. Tip number five, this is for low-risk healthy women at term, of course, but tip number five comes to laboring at home. Labor at home as long as possible. In early labor, we're so excited that we're in labor that we often tend to rush over to our birthplace just to be told to start following hospital policies, which often are no eating and drinking when you're in labor and etc. But this also plays out in other ways, such as not being able to rest because they have to come in and do vitals and adjust your monitors, and also dad not being able to rest. And so laboring at home is an opportunity that you can eat your own food and rest in your own bed and labor comfortably in an environment that you're comfortable in until active labor really kicks in. So if you can labor at home comfortably until you're in active labor, that's the best chance you're going to have at having the truly natural birth that you're really shooting for. And last but not least, tip number six is knowing your birth options. And really, that's tips one through five, isn't it? Knowing about what the C-section rate is at the location that you're choosing to give birth, knowing the difference between having your water broken versus letting it break on its own, knowing that you can or cannot have a doula in your chosen birth environment, if you can labor inside or outside of the bed, can you push in alternative birthing positions? You need to know what all of your options are. And so taking a childbirth education class can help educate you on the birth options in your area. Hiring a doula who's experienced with the hospitals or the midwives in your area can help you know what options you have to take advantage of. All of these things that we talked about in tips one through five really encompass tip number six, which is just know your birth options before you walk into your birth. Because if you don't know your options, then you don't have any. So if you're in agreement with any of these tips from today, I want you to go right down here and I want you to press that thumbs up like button and let us know. Otherwise, I'll see you in one of my other Midwife Monday videos right here up on the screen. Thanks for watching this Midwife Monday. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.